Morning. Today we are going to discuss United Nations Organization. This United Nations Organization was established in 1945 after 7 rounds of conferences, and in 8th conference, that is San Francisco, that is it was started with 51 original members of the United Nations Organization. That is the preamble of this Charter of United Nations. It says that here, that is the United Nations Organization is established for the lasting peace, which is devastated from 2 world wars. For that purpose, that is in order to establish international peace and security. For that, this United Nations Organization is performing the functions. Then it has a legal personality, what we have already discussed in the reparation case, that is reparation for the services suffered in the services of United Nations. In that, it is already said that it is United Nations is being an international personality. Means it has certain rights and duties under international law. It can claim compensation against the state. Then this United Nations Organization was established with certain main purposes. Purposes is that is maintenance of international peace and security, and it has certain purposes. And that is original members, that is 51 members. Conditions for membership, there are certain conditions which are to be accepted in order to become a member of the Charter of United Nations. The suspension of that is members and expulsion of the members. These are the, and Article 7, which deals with the, that is organs of United Nations. There are 6 organs. With that 6 organs, it is performing the functions. And this Charter of United Nations, This is the multilateral treaty agreement which are entered by the states. For that it is called as a charter or agreement. Now we will go with first, what are the purposes and the principles of Charter of United Nations. First purpose is that Article 1, one of the Charter of United Nations deals with the purposes. These purposes of United Nations are in 4 in number. 1, to maintain international peace and security. 2, to develop friendly relations among the nations. 3rd one is to establish international cooperation in solving the international problems like economic, social and humanitarian character. 4th one is to make United Nations as a center for, in order to attainment of these purposes. Now we will go with one by one. That is what are the purposes of the Charter of United Nations. It is purpose is one, that is maintenance of international peace and security. The utmost purpose of the United Nations is maintenance of international peace and security. To that end, in order to establish international peace and security, effective and collective measures to be taken in order to prevent any threat to the peace, removal of act of aggression, then the suppression of the any acts which led to international peace, then that is peaceful means in order to bring that conformed with the principles of justice and international law. To that end, it is first principle is to be maintenance of international peace and security. This maintenance of peace and security is lies on the, that is the, what is called as the Security Council, is the as the main organ in this, and the General Assembly. Now we'll go with, later we'll discuss with that. Then first one is maintenance of international peace and security. Second purpose is to develop friendly relations among nations. Second purpose is to maintain relationship between the states based on the principle of sovereign equality. That is the first, second purpose of this international organization. Second, that is friendly relations. Friendly relations ought to be established based on sovereign equality. In international law, it is already considered, already explained that. That is, in international, each state is sovereign and equal, whatever may be their strength or size. But every state is sovereign, means they are having certainly supreme power and independence to make any laws in order to maintain internal security and external aggression. For that, every state is supreme and it is what is called as sovereign functions. For that, every state is equal, and also that is what we already discussed, that is the essential elements of state without which the state cannot form. One is permanent population, territory, definite territory. Third one is government, and fourth one is the capacity of a state to enter into relationship with other state or the sovereign. Now, with regarding to permanent population, that permanent population is already said that that state must contain population permanently, and they should not be nomadic persons. Means nomadic in that that is a people who are wandering from one place to another place. They are not called as a permanent population. For that, it is the people, they have to decide, they have to self-determine what is their that is economic rights, what is their social rights and political rights. They have to determine their own rights, and this was again reiterated and emphasized in the South Africa in Namibia, South African in Namibia case. In that it was said to develop friendly relations on the basis of sovereign equality as well as self-determination. The self-determination is that the peoples have to determine their own rights in accordance with the political status and with the rights and duties, and with regarding to economic, whatever the natural resources which are available in that territory, they have to make plan and they have to determine according to that, that is the friendly relations to be developed. Second. The third one, that is purpose is to international cooperation in solving international problems of that is economic, social and humanitarian character, and to encourage with the human rights and fundamental freedoms for all the people irrespective of their color combination or their race or sex. This is the third it is purpose to develop international cooperation among the people. Fourth one, to make United Nations organization a center for the attainment of these that is purposes as a common end. These are the what is called as the purpose of the Charter of United Nations, which are in four in number. Second one, Article 2 of Charter of United Nations deals with the purposes of the Charter of United Nations. The purposes are Article 2 subclass 1 deals with United Nations is based on the sovereign equality of all the members. The states are based on the sovereign equality. That is, whether the states may be either may be different in size or in population or in that is in their strength, either developed state or developing states, but also that is based on the sovereign equality of the states. Third, second one is that is second under Article 2. Here it is dealing with that is principle 2, principle 1 sovereign equality, Second one said that that is all the members of the United Nations, they have to ensure the rights and benefits arising from this membership should fulfill in good faith in accordance with the Charter of United Nations. Whatever the that is a rights and benefits which are arising from their membership, those will be the members are under obligation to fulfill in good faith. That is the obligations which are assumed by them in accordance with the Charter of United Nations. Second, the third one is that international disputes ought to be settled in that is peacefully. The members of this international that is members of this Charter of United Nations, they have to resolve their dispute in a peaceful manner. That is negotiation, mediation, then what is called as arbitration and others, peaceful means. Like that, that is, they have to make sure that not to make any, that is, endanger the international peace and security. That is the fourth. Article is 2, Section 4 deals with the use of threat or that is force against any states. Territorial integrity or political independence of the state. That is, the members are under obligation not to use any threat or force against each other's state's political independence or territorial integrity of the state. Then, Article 2, subclass 5, it deals with, that is, your non-members also under obligation and to assure their assistance in resolving the disputes in a pacific manner, and they have also to ensure that in maintenance of international peace and security. Then Article 7 says that is principle of non-intervention in the domestic affairs of any state. That is, Charter of United Nations makes that no member has the right to intervene the domestic affairs of any state. Even the Charter of United Nations also has not having any right to intervene in the domestic affairs of the state. Like this, these are what is called as principle 2 of the Charter of United Nations. Under that, that is principle 2, 4 and 2, 7 are most important with regard to the disputes. For example, that is you already know that it is a in Nicaragua's case, that is ICJ held that is USA is held liable for the intervention of the domestic affairs of Nicaragua, and that is by using threat of force against the territorial integrity or the political independence of the state. In that way, it is important. Next one, Article 3. Of the Charter of United Nations deals with the original members. Again it comes that who are the members of Charter of United Nations? That is, the members who are signed on the 8th conference of San Francisco are the members who are present at that time. San Francisco conference are in 51 members. Those are called as original members of the Charter of United Nations. Then Article 4 of Charter of United Nations again makes that conditions for membership. What are the conditions to be fulfilled in order to become membership? There are 4 conditions which are laid down under the Charter of United Nations to become a member of Charter of United Nations. First one, the state want to become member of United Nations. It must be a state in the meaning of state. That means a state has to fulfill all the essential elements of statehood. You already know that, there is no need to repeat that again. One. Second one, that state must be peace-loving state. The state which want to become member of the Charter of United Nations, that state must be peace-loving. That state must be interested into settle their disputes in a peaceful manner. Second, the third one is to accept the obligations which are laid down by Charter of United Nations That is, the members who want to become a member of Charter of United Nations, they have to accept the obligations in good faith and they have to perform in that good faith. Fourth one, that is, it is a state's willingness and capacity to carry out the obligations laid down under the Charter of United Nations. The fourth one, it is the willingness of the state, that is the state's to carry out the, there's obligations laid down by the Charter of United Nations, or whether it has the, what is the capacity of the state to carry out those measures. For example, the measures laid down in the chapter 7 of the Charter of United Nations, what is called as collective enforcement measures. In such cases, that is the, it requires the willingness and to carry out the obligations and its capacity to implement those obligations laid according to the Charter of United Nations. These are Article 4 deals with the conditions for membership. Article 5 deals with suspension of membership of the from the Charter of United Nations. That is, a member of Charter of United Nations can be suspended by the Security Council on the, that is, recommendation of the Security Council. You can suspend. Then last one is Article 6 of the Charter of United Nations deals with the expulsion of the membership. That is, if a member of the Charter of United Nations is persistently violate the principles laid down under Charter of United Nations Article 2, if the that country will be permanently removed from the membership of the United Nations on the recommendation of the Security Council by the General Assembly. Today we are going to discuss General Assembly. General Assembly, you know that it is one of the principal organ of the Charter of United Nations. This General Assembly is consist of, that is, all the members of the Charter of United Nations. What now we are having, that is, 193 members of the United Nations organization. All those 193 members are the members of the General Assembly. And each member can represent 5 representatives, and the General Assembly can decide matters on important questions like maintenance of international peace and security, election for non-permanent members of the Security Council, election of members of the Security Council, Trusteeship Council, or Economics and Social Council, for admission, suspension of the members or expulsion, or trusteeship functions, questions, and budgetary matters, or will be decided by the 2/3 majority of the members who are present at voting. Each member of the General Assembly is having one vote, and all states are based on the equality of the states. Other than what is called as procedural matters or other matters, it requires a simple majority of the members who are present at voting. This is the constitution, or what is called as the composition of the General Assembly. Then, what are the functions of the General Assembly? Powers and functions. First function is the deliberative function. Under that, the primary function of Charter of United Nations is that is maintenance of international peace and security. It lies on the, that is, primary responsibility of the Security Council, not the General Assembly. But General Assembly has taken those issues whenever the Security Council became paralyzed or ineffective to take any action due to the veto powers of the permanent members. For that purpose, this Uniting for Peace resolution was established in 1950. We will discuss later. Then, supervisory function. Third one is financial functions, elective functions and miscellaneous functions of the General Assembly. That already said, General Assembly is one of the principal organ of the United Nations organization. Under that, first what is called as deliberative functions. The deliberative functions means that is General Assembly can discuss any matter. It is having the wide powers under Article 10 of the Charter of United Nations. It has the power to discuss any matter. Any matter can be investigated or review or supervise or that is criticize the work relating to the Charter of United Nations or the functions which fall under the Charter of United Nations or the objects of the Charter of United Nations. Either it can discuss and report those matters as a whole of the other organization or any organs that is including the specialized agencies. That is what I said here. That is the General Assembly can discuss any matter. There is no restriction on the General Assembly to discuss or to review or to investigate the matter. But there is only one restriction or limitation which is imposed on the General Assembly function, that whenever the Security Council is taking any action or when it is discussing the matter, being its primary responsibility. Otherwise, whenever there is a threat or act of aggression likely causing any threat to the maintenance of international peace and security, those matters should not be discussed by the General Assembly. That is the only one restriction General Assembly, because it is the main function of the Security Council. When it is dealing, that General Assembly cannot interfere with that matter. Otherwise, that is the General Assembly can discuss and it is having the wide powers in with regard to the functions of the Charter of United Nations. Then, that is the General Assembly can discuss any matter with fall under the Charter of United Nations, or any member of the Charter of United Nations or any organs if brought the dispute or any likely causing any endangered to the maintenance of international peace and security, the General Assembly is having the power to discuss on any matter, what is called as deliberative functions, which are unlimited. Then, for that deliberative functions, what is I said? There is a maintenance of international peace and security as the main purpose of Charter of United Nations. To that extent, whatever that is then any act of aggression or any nature of acts which threatening to the peace and security, to that extent, it can take any measures for that. But whenever that is Security Council became paralyzed due to the ineffective act or what is called as the veto powers which are exercised by permanent members, for that the obligation or the main function of the maintenance of international peace and security lies on the General Assembly. That is only when Security Council became ineffective or could not take any action with regard to the maintenance of international peace and security, General Assembly can exercise that matter and it can take any measures in order to maintenance of international peace and security. For peace resolution, which was established in 1950, because in Korean crisis, when the Russian government has exercised veto powers in order to take any measures with regarding to the Korean crisis, at that time Russia has exercised veto powers, for that Security Council became unable to take any action for this in order to maintain international peace and security, that is General Assembly has established what is called as Uniting Peace for Resolution Commission or Peace Observation Commission in 1950. This commission it consists of 14 members, and including the members of Security Council, and their function is to report and to observe the functions of the Charter of United Nations, and the General Assembly taking certain that is what is active measures with regarding to this that is United Nations peacekeeping emergency forces, and for that this General Assembly was established. The active role of this United Nations peacekeeping is that is in case of Korean crisis or Suez Canal or Congo crisis or Middle East, in this that is Gulf War, in these cases that is United Nations peacekeeping taken that is active role when the Security Council has become incapable or unable to take any actions. In that way, that is this peacekeeping force or uniting for peace resolution, which was established and that is taken care by the General Assembly. General Assembly can use enforcement measures, including armed forces, which are that is mentioned under the enforcement measures under Chapter 7, in order to maintain international peace and security. This is what is called as that is uniting for peace resolution with regard to the maintenance of international peace and security. It can take any measures in order to maintain international peace and security, or in order to pursue the functions which fall under the scope of the Charter of United Nations. Next function is the supervisory function. The General Assembly can supervise not only on the other organs of the Charter of United Nations, but also that is specialized agencies, and also it can also having the that is supervisory function on the that is Trusteeship Council, as well as that is what is called as that is Economic Social Council, and also it is also having the right to control or right to supervise on the Secretary General. And it receives the special reports from the Security Council and Secretary General. To that extent, it can make supervision on the other organs, including the specialized agencies. Next function is the financial function. Again, it is the most important function of the that is General Assembly. General Assembly is having the there is a plenary organ or the primary that is principal organ of the Charter of United Nations. It considers and approves the budget relating to the organization, and also it can apportion or it can that is appropriate those expenses among the members of the Charter of United Nations, and also it also performs that is acceptance of the budget and financial arrangements with regarding to the that is specialized agencies. In that in case of that is what is called as certain expenses for the expenses of United Nations, that case came before the that is United Nations. It was requested by the General Assembly as the advisory opinion with regarding to certain expenses of the United Nations organization. At that time, the United for Peace Resolution, that is the expenses of these Congo crisis or Suez Canal or Middle East, or that is what is called as that is emergency forces, but that is all the expenses which were incurred with that. That is, at that time, that is Russia has refused to pay that expenses, and it was held that it is the main function of the Security Council. And it is the responsibility of the Security Council to maintain international peace and security. For that, it is not the obligation of the members of the that is the Charter of United Nations. For that, that was brought before the International Court of Justice. International Court of Justice held that the expenses of the that is peacekeeping force are the expenses of the Charter of United Nations. For that, the resolution made by this General Assembly with regarding to the maintenance of international peace and security or the functions of the Charter of United Nations, that resolution taken by United Nations General Assembly was valid, and all the expenses of this organization are the expenses of the members of Charter of United Nations, and those expenses are to be to be apportioned between the members. And whenever a member who has having the that is arrears of payment for exceeding 2 years, that member is not having any that is voting rights under the Charter of United Nations. That is with regard to Russian government, it was held that. For that, it was said that General Assembly is having the plenary organ of the Charter of United Nations. It can approve and it can apportion the that is expenses with regard to the Charter of United Nations. Then, what is called as elective functions? Elective functions under that, that is General Assembly can elect the that is the non-permanent members of Security Council, that is 10 non-permanent members. That's what 10 members we already know that recently that is India is also considered is also that is what is elected as the non-permanent members, and these non-permanent that is election of these non-permanent members, it can be made by the General Assembly for every 2 years. That is India is also that is elected as a for 20 and 22. In that way, that is General Assembly can perform its function, elective functions, and also it also elects 54 members for the ECOSOC, that is Economic Social Council and Trusteeship Council, and 15 judges of the ICJ who are elected for the International Court of Justice separately by both the General Assembly as well as the Security Council, and the Secretary General is also appointed by the General Assembly on the recommendation of the Security Council. To this extent, that is General Assembly performs the elective functions of the Charter of United Nations Organization. Then miscellaneous functions with regard to that is a member of the Charter of United Nations, either in order to admit that member to the Charter of United Nations, or that member can be suspended from the membership, or for expulsion of that member for persistent violation of the principles of Charter of United Nations. For this, it requires the that is recommendations of the Security Council, and the member either he can admit or he can suspend under Article 4, 5 and 6 for violation of the Charter of United Nations by the General Assembly on the recommendation of the Security Council. To that extent, that is General Assembly performs the functions which is entrusted under the Charter of United Nations. Morning. Now we'll go with the second organ of the Charter of United Nations. It's called as Security Council. Security Council is the main and principal organ of the Charter of United Nations, and because under Article 24 of the Charter of United Nations, it is provided that Security Council is one of the primary organ or primary responsibility lies on Security Council for maintenance of international peace and security. For that, it is called as an important organ of the Charter of United Nations. This consists of 15 members, 10 non-permanent members, and 5 permanent members like China, Russia, Britain, France, and America. Then these 10 non-permanent members are elected by General Assembly for a term of 2 years, and these persons again they can be continued after their term. Voting powers, that is each member has one vote. Decisions on procedural matters shall be made by 9 affirmative votes of the 9 members. On substantial matters, that is important matters, it requires that is 9 affirmative votes of the members, including the affirmative votes of permanent members. For example, measures taken under Chapter 7, that is Chapter 7 deals with the enforcement measures. In such cases, it requires 9 affirmative votes, including 5 permanent members. And the security council, that is the five permanent members are also having the veto power. What is veto power means? Veto power is the negative vote which can be exercised by the permanent members of the Charter of United Nations. It is also another one is also it is a privilege to these specialized that is permanent members or what is called as double veto. They can also double that is two times they can cast their vote. That exercising double vote or by veto, which makes the negative of the decision. That decision cannot be taken by the General Assembly or Security Council with regard to that function. That is what is called as veto and double veto powers. This is the composition of Security Council. Next, what are the powers and functions of the Security Council? First one, that is what is the purpose which is laid down under Article 1 of the Charter of United Nations? Maintenance of peace and international peace and security. To that end, measures to be taken in order to put an end that threat to peace, breach of peace or act of aggression, and to take measures to adjust or to the for the in conference with the that is international law or with the Charter of United Nations. Here, as a Security Council as being the that is a main organ or primary organ of the organ in establishment in maintenance of international peace and security, the members of that is the Security Council have agreed to carry out the functions of the organization and to act on it according to the Charter of United Nations under Article 25. That is, the members are agreed to carry out the functions of organizations and also to act on the behalf of the Charter of United Nations. One. Second one, with regard to Pacific settlement of disputes, that is under Article 33 of the Charter of United Nations. That is called as Chapter 6 of the United Nations. It is called as specific means. Under that, the parties to any international disputes or the continuance of that dispute which likely endanger the maintenance of international peace and security. First of all, the members to resolve their dispute by that is negotiation, by it is inquiry, mediation, conciliation, arbitration or judicial settlement or resort to regional arrangements and or other any other means of specific means of their own choice. But Article 33 it was laid down. Again, if the party the parties to the dispute, if they fail to settle their disputes peacefully, it is provided under Article 33, then they can refer that matter to the Security Council. Under Article 34 and 37, the Security Council may investigate what is the that is a measure what is the that is a thing which happened to the threat or threat to peace. In such cases, after investigating, the Security Council can make appropriate, that is, recommendations with regard to the procedure and methods of adjustment. And it also, even if the parties are not, that is, find a solution under these specific means, the Security Council may refer that matter to ICJ. ICJ as an international, that is, one of the organ of the Charter of United Nations, it can refer. Then the Security Council can take certain sanctions against the parties who are not settled the disputes peacefully. After determining that whether there is any existing of any threat of peace or it is a threat to the peace or to the it is act of aggression, once it decides, it makes recommendations to the measures to restore international peace and security. even if it is not found any solution, then it will decide that is what are the provisional measures ought to be taken under Article 40, 41 and 42, what is called as provisional measures. Those provisional measures include either maybe it may be complete or partial interruption to economic relations, like that is disconnecting the what is called as telecommunication or communication, or stopping of this import and export to the states, or by making demonstrations, or by embargoes, and by other means it can take that is actions with regarding to that the state which failed to follow the recommendations made by the Security Council in order to settle the disputes. Then even if the Security Council is found inadequate under provisional measures, then it takes actions by rail or by land or by that is naval and sea. These are the certain measures which can be taken under Article 43 to 51, what is called as enforcement measures under Charter of United Nations. And it also under Article 48, the Security Council also may ask the members of the Charter of United Nations to make availability of the armed forces to the organization. Then that is these are the functions with regarding to. First one is maintenance of international peace and security. With that, under that, that is the Security Council has achieved certain measures. It is not completely failed, but you know what is called as in 1950, that is North Korea attacked on South Korea. In that, Security Council failed to take action because already said that is a negative vote or what is called as veto power, which was exercised by Russia. Again, in 1971, there was a dispute with regarding to India and Pakistan war. At that time, there is veto exercised by Russia in favor of India. Again, it has sent certain emergency forces to Congo and Cyprus in order to suppress or order to cease fire with regard to that areas. And it's also sent certain there is what is called as peacekeepers are observers to Arab-Israeli conflict, what already said that is in reparation case, or in Palestine, or the Gulf War, which is taken under 1990. These are the certain achievements of the Security Council, but the Security Council has paralyzed only due to this exercise of veto powers by the permanent members. But it is wrong to say that Security Council has completely failed in order to maintain internal peace and security, but it prevented the future war. First one, maintenance of international peace and security. In that, second function of the Security Council is the elective functions. With regard to elective functions, the Security Council may elect the members of Security Council as well as the General Assembly. Separately, it elects the judges of, that is, International Court of Justice. The Security Council recommends for appointment of Secretary General. This is the elective function of Security Council with regarding to election. Third one, supervisory function. The supervisory function in this, that is, the Security Council supervises the functions of organs of the organization, other organs. It can also control the trusteeship council in its territory. Lastly, constitutional functions. Again, under Article 108 of the Charter of United Nations, that is, if there is any amendment to the charter is required, that amendment can be made by 2/3 members of the General Assembly and ratified by 2/3 members of the Charter who are present and voting, including 5 permanent members. That is, 5 permanent members which are required in order to make any amendment to the Charter of United Nations. This is about the function and power of the Security Council.